recent survey found that 3 out of 4 employees don't think they're strongly valued on the job. And nearly half say they're not highly satisfied with their supervisors. That means they hate their boss. The problem has spawned an entire industry about what can be done to fix it. Joining us to discuss this is workplace expert Bob Rosner, author of The Boss's Survival Guide. Good morning, Bob.
Good morning.
How big a problem is this, really?
Oh, this is a huge problem. 3/4 of the people, according to that poll, don't feel respected at work. Let me give you a real example, though. There was a holiday party somebody wrote to me about, and they handed everybody an envelope when they were coming in. It took a while for people to open the envelopes. They realized they were pink slips. They'd all been laid off.
Yeah.
It's tough out there.
You talk about employee dissatisfaction, but I also think what's interesting about the book is you sort of give it a time frame in the sense that you say people were always dissatisfied, but after the recession, things really started changing. What happened?
Well, I personally responded to 50,000 emails, and I thought in the recession we'd hit bottom. But in fact, people are still frustrated and upset. Well, there's a lot of reasons. People feel overworked. People feel underappreciated. Companies communicate poorly. But the bottom line is people get upset being treated like paupers when the executives are getting huge paychecks.
And
so there's a lot of anger out there.
And the fact of the matter is, Bob, when people are unhappy, it's bad for business, isn't it?
It is. There's studies that say $350 billion unhappy employees affect businesses. But one study found employees who are happy are 12% more productive. Mm. Companies are more profitable. Companies are worth more. Bottom line is, it makes sense to have happy people, but the recession created a lot of bad habits in management, and that's really a problem.
You always hear about these companies like Google and Zappos that have perks like fresh juice bars and cafeteria food and sleeping pods. Do those actually help? Does that make people happier?
I'm going to upset all the vegans out there. There's icing and there's cake. Perks are great icing. Icing always tastes good. We like that. The bottom line is the cake. People have to feel respected and have to feel paid fairly. And you can't, perks won't overcome that.
Mm-hmm. There is one company that we've read about, a tiny startup company that's actually taking a survey of its employees every week. What's happening there exactly?
Tiny Pulse is an interesting company. They listen to the employees and what's going on, and then they encourage management to do something about it, to act on it. Mm-hmm. It's not good enough to just listen and make noise with surveys. You've got to do something. And I think that's a good trend in the workplace, paying more attention to where employees are.
A conversation with your workers, and a continuing conversation.
Yes, and a lot of companies, when they have a problem, want to go to expensive consultants. There's a whole lot of resources in your own building to solve problems. Go to them first.
I wouldn't mind a juice bar, though. Bob Rosner, thank you so much.
Thank you.